So you have stomach ulcers. Yeah, I know. It's horrible. I had it. It's an absolute ongoing nightmare with no end in sight, endless medications and endless stomach pain and discomfort. In this video, I'm going to explain to you what it is, how it works, what really causes it and what doesn't, and why the treatment is okay because it manages the pain and the discomfort, but it doesn't solve the problem and you're stuck with it for the rest of your life. Apparently. Okay, but you're not. I don't have it anymore. Welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. I used to suffer from stomach ulcers, amongst many other things. Hell, I'm 60. You know, what do you expect? I had arthritis. I was obese. I had insulin resistance. I had heart arrhythmias. I had gout and I had stomach ulcers. I was a typical messed up 60-year-old. Now I have none of those things because I've managed to fix them all. But this video specifically is about stomach ulcers. Now, a stomach ulcer is not caused by stress. It is not caused by any particular food that you eat. It is at its root caused by a bacteria. It's actually a bacterial infection. And you may have heard this already. It's called Helicobacter pylori. You don't have to remember that. It is a bacteria that lives in your stomach and you pass it on to the next person and the next person and the next person. And it does the rounds in our community. And at any one moment in time, probably about a third of us are carrying it in our stomach. Now, that doesn't mean that a third of us have ulcers, because it doesn't necessarily cause an ulcer. It only causes an ulcer if it's really happy in your stomach. So if your stomach is a really welcoming environment for this bacteria, it will flourish, it will grow, it will spread, and it will destroy your stomach lining, opening sores, wounds inside your stomach. So your stomach wall is no longer protected against the burn of the acid of your stomach. And your stomach acid then burns into those ulcers, into those sores, and that's what gives you the pain of the stomach ulcer. Now, if your stomach is not a welcoming environment and the bacteria are not happy there, they will only live long enough maybe for you to pass them back on by through saliva or through coughing, and they'll escape. But they will die inside your stomach if it's not a good environment. So you need your stomach to be a healthy place for you, but a hostile place for the Helicobacter pylori. Now, if you have stomach ulcers right now, this approach it's not going to work for you straight away, because you first have to be in remission. You have to wait until you've got one of those gaps when you're not actually suffering from a stomach ulcer before you can start fixing the issue. So if you are in pain, just get the antibiotic already. Get the antibiotic, kill the bacteria, then your stomach is clear. Then we let your ulcer heal. And then before you get infected again, because you will, because that's what happens, we will change the environment in your stomach so that when you do get it, it's not happy, it doesn't flourish, it doesn't reproduce successfully, it doesn't have time to create new ulcers, and you will kill it in your stomach. Okay, so what do we do? There are two things. One is you want your stomach to be a very unpleasant place for the bacteria in the first place. And secondly, you don't want to feed them. Okay, you don't feed the monster under your bed. It doesn't go away like that. So the first thing, to have a hostile environment in your stomach means you need your stomach acid to be very strong. Now, that might sound weird, because if you have ulcers, your treatment, part of your treatment usually involves antacids in some form or omeprazole to dilute the acid, but so that it doesn't burn. But that's only because you have an ulcer, you have a sore, the acid is burning it, you take that medication to weaken the acid so you don't feel the pain. It doesn't solve the problem. The bacteria is very happy there. The second thing that happens, when your stomach acid is a bit weak, you tend to have acid reflux or heartburn, where the acid comes up into your esophagus and it burns you because it's not supposed to be there. Your esophagus doesn't have a protective lining against this. acid. So actually, when you're getting acid reflux, it's not because your acid is too strong, it's because it's not strong enough. And when it's not strong enough, the valve at the top of your stomach tends to relax and open, and the acid can come up. I've done videos about that. I'll link them down below here to explain how the acid reflux thing works. If you have acid reflux, click a like on this video. Let's see. So if you have a very acidic stomach, the bacteria won't like it and they won't flourish there, and you won't get acid reflux. So we need to address that. The other problem, of course, with diluting your stomach acid is it doesn't work as well for digesting your food, particularly proteins. And so instead of dissolving all the proteins in your stomach, some of them will go through into your intestine where they should not be. And you can have autoimmune issues and other gut issues and digestive problems and intolerances and even allergies from that. So there are a lot of reasons to keep your stomach acid right. The second thing is we don't want to feed them. So what you eat is very important, because the bacteria, when they're in your stomach, can only eat what you eat. Okay? And guess what it is that they love most? Sugar. That's right, sugar, glucose. So carbohydrates, starch. So here is another reason to be on a low carbohydrate diet, because then you do not feed the Helicobacter pylori, the bacteria that's in your stomach, and it can't grow and flourish and infest you and create ulcers. So you need to change your diet, and you need to be on a low sugar diet. Now, there are lots of other reasons to be on a low sugar diet: obesity, diabetes, heart disease, various inflammatory conditions, just a nightmare of conditions, hormone dysfunctions, lots of reasons to go on a low sugar diet. That's not what this video is about. This video is about gut bacteria and, or stomach bacteria specifically, that create ulcers. If you don't give them sugar, they have nothing to eat. And you don't need sugar. I mean, everybody knows that now. You don't need any sugar. You don't need any carbohydrates in your diet. You can operate perfectly well off fat and oil as a fuel source. They can't. So stick it to them and stop feeding them with sugar. Now, once you don't have an ulcer, okay, let's say you're just in a little window when you don't have the infection at the moment, or maybe you've done a course of antibiotics to get rid of it, cut the sugar out of your diet, and we can help you with that on this channel. Subscribe to this channel, become a member of the channel, then you can ask me questions personally, and I can even help you with a program to get your diet right if you like. That's what I do. I'm a nutritionist. But get yourself onto a low sugar diet, whether that's paleo, Atkins, you can be a vegan on a ketogenic diet, you can be a carnivore. All these low sugar diets, all of them will help for this. How do you get your stomach acid right? Firstly, by not eating sugar, because high sugar just sabotages the regulation of everything, including your stomach acid. But a real good hack, and I've done a video on this too, is apple cider vinegar. A glass of water in the morning with a dessert spoon of apple cider vinegar in it, and you can put a little squirt of lemon juice for the taste if you want, and you down that once a day on an empty stomach. That will help keep your stomach acid at the correct pH level. pH is just a measure of acidity. It'll help keep it acidic enough to be a bad environment for the bacteria and to be a much better environment for you. It will help you digest your food. It will control your hunger cravings, which is handy, especially if you're trying to lose weight. And it will prevent acid reflux. It will eventually prevent acid reflux. So there you go. You can cure this by getting your acidity right and then cutting out sugars. You won't be feeding the bacteria anymore. And even when you do get infected, and you will, because we all do, it'll come and it'll go, and you won't even know it was there. So there you go. Please subscribe to the channel. Share this. Share this with somebody you know who has this problem, because it's so easy to fix, and you don't need all these medications, and you won't need to keep going on antibiotics every 4 months. This you can fix with diet, with nutrition, like most things. All right, thank you for your time and good luck with it. Let me hear from you, especially if you try this. Come back to the video and tell me how you've done.